Hello, my name is Veerle Haverals and I work for the University of Antwerp, Belgium. In this ILSA project video, you will receive an overview on how to perform long-term preparation of speeches about international current affairs. We continue to build on what you have learned in the previous modules, that is, the modules on subtitling, on simultaneous interpreting, and on intralingual respeaking. In the international context, some events might be well known in advance, such as royal weddings, presidential elections, Oscars, sport events, and championships. For this kind of events, you can prepare yourself fully. Make sure you have in-depth knowledge about the topics that will be raised, and have a lexicon that is ready to use. Explore what would be relevant topics in your regional environment that could require interlingual respeaking. Examples could be speeches by CEOs of international companies. In one of the books of Dummies, Software, you will find a dummy book on Dragon Naturally Speaking. In this book, Stefania Diamond is explaining the following. If you're likely to use terms from some specialized vocabulary, you can make a list of such terms and give them to Dragon Professional Individual in one fell swoop. For example, Queen's Gambit Declined is the name of a chess opening. Each of the three words is surely already in the Dragon Professional Individual General English vocabulary. But Dragon Professional Individual doesn't know that these three words have a special capitalization pattern when they appear together. If you were to dictate documents about chess, you would want to include Queen's Gambit Declined on one line of your list. You can create a list and use the import list of words or phrases box as shown on screen. Follow these steps. Create a text file in which each line is a written form of a vocabulary entry you would like to add. At the end of any line where you want a different spoken form, add a backslash and then the shorthand alias you want to speak. From the Accuracy Center, click the Import a list of words or phrases link, or use the mouse or commands, and from the Dragon Bar, go to Vocabulary, Import list of words or phrases. A screen pops up with the word Import lists of words or phrases. You also see the option to preview the list of unknown words. If you wish to do that, select the box. Click Next. You are asked to add the file. Click the Add File button, click Finish. A summary box shows you how many words were added to your vocabulary. Review the list of words to make sure they are real words that you really want. Don't add words that you use infrequently. This is especially true if they sound like some other words that you use often. Sometimes individual proper nouns that you want from a document are actually common words, except that their capitalization or lack of capitalization makes them special for you. A sports team named Bingo, for example, or an internet domain that uses a person's name. Practice with different topics and with different levels of difficulty. Examples are the next Olympic Games, a financial crisis, the next World Cup football, an incident in American politics, war and crisis situations, an incident in British politics, an incident in European politics, an international juridical event. You can use the practice videos and from now on skip the beginner's level and go for intermediate or advanced instead. For both intralingual and interlingual live subtitling, a good preparation is very important. Prepare for interlingual speaking in the same way as for an interpreting assignment. Create multilingual glossaries with difficult terminology, including proper names, names of institutions and organizations. It also helps to look up multiple articles on the subject and, if necessary, to look for videos about or by the speaker. Then prepare yourself for intralingual re-speaking assignment. Make sure that all the terms in your glossary are reproduced correctly by the speech recognition. If this is not the case, add the terms to your speech recognition lexicon and use macros to avoid persistent speech recognition errors. If you are working live on a news-related event, for example, rest assured that a multitude of topics will come your way at top speed. You will have to be able to adopt in a very flexible mindset to tackle that kind of speed. And you must make sure that you always end topic or subtopic before starting to re-speak the next one.